Hi, this is Alfauzia Nihar from At Home Tuition. Welcome to our session today. The topic that we are going to discuss in our today's video is Baye's Theorem. Baye's Theorem is a mathematical equation that is used in probability and statistics. This will help us to calculate conditional probability. In other words, it is used to calculate the probability of an event that is based on its association with another event. This Baye's theorem is also known as Baye's law or Baye's rule. All these words denote the same theorem. One key to understanding the essence of Baye's theorem is to recognize that we are dealing with sequential events, whereby new additional information is obtained for a subsequent event. So, in this topic Baye's theorem, you should know about two important terms, prior probability and posterior probability. These are the common terms that are used. Okay, first let us see what is meant by prior probability. Prior probability is nothing but it is an initial probability value that originally obtained before any additional information is obtained. Now let us see what is meant by posterior probability. Posterior probability is a probability value that has been revised after using additional information. So, this is the later obtained information and this is the information which we have initially. Hope you are clear with these two terms. Baye's theorem is a result in probability theory that relates the conditional probabilities. If A and B denote two events, probability of A given B denotes the conditional probability of A occurring given that B occurs. The two conditional probabilities, probability of A given B and probability of B given A, are general different. So Baye's theorem gives the relationship between these two. Hope you got an idea on Baye's theorem now. Okay, let us see the statement of Baye's theorem first. Baye's theorem relates the conditional and marginal probabilities of stochastic event A and B. Probability of A given B is equal to probability of B given A times probability of A divided by probability of B. Now, let me explain what each term in Baye's theorem that has a conventional name too. Let us discuss that. Probability of A, this is called the prior probability. Or you can also say this as marginal probability of A. It is prior in the sense that it does not take into account any information about B. Does this make sense to you so far? Okay, let us see what is this. Probability of A given B is the conditional probability of A given B. It is also called the posterior probability because it is derived from the specific value of B, or you can say that it depends upon the specific value of B. Probability of B given A is the conditional probability of B given A. Probability of B in the denominator is the prior or marginal probability of B, and this acts as a normalizing constant. Hope you are clear with the statement of Baye's theorem now. Okay, now let us see the proof of Baye's theorem. The probability of two events A and B happening, probability of A intersection B, that is the probability of A, P of A times the probability of B given that A has occurred. Let this be equation number 1. On the other hand, the probability of A and B is also equal to the probability of B times the probability of A given B. Am I right? Let this equation be equation number 2. The left sides of both the equations are same, so you can equate the right sides of both the equations. So equating the two will yield that if you divide the entire equation throughout by probability of B, P of B, we will get this equation known as Baye's theorem. So this is the basis of the statistical inference. Hope you are clear with the proof. So to derive this theorem, we start from the definition of the conditional probability. The probability of an event A given event B is probability of this thing. I have just rewritten it. Hope you are clear with this step. Likewise, probability of event B given event A. And rearranging and combining these equations, we find this. And this you can also write the lemma in the same way. Lemma is sometimes called the product rule of probabilities. This theorem can also be restated in an alternative form. Okay, let me give you the alternative form of Baye's theorem. Baye's theorem is often embellished by noting that probability of B is equal to probability of A intersection B plus probability of A complement intersection B. So this can be written as, you can use the conditional probability formula here. Please note that A complement A raised to C is nothing but complementary event of A. Or you can also say that as not A. Both are same. So the theorem, Baye's theorem, can be restated as, hope you're clear with this form. Okay, you should also be familiar with the alternative form of Baye's theorem. Okay, I have just replaced P of B in the denominator by this expression. So the generalized form would be, where AI is the form of a partition of the even space. So for any AI in the partition, this is the generalized form of the Baye's theorem. Hope you're clear with this theorem. Baye's theorem can also be written in terms of likelihood, in terms of odds and likelihood ratio, and it can also be written for probability densities. We can see those types terms in terms of other things in the separate video. Now we can see an example, and let's see how to apply the statement or the formula of the Baye's theorem. Here is an example. Please read the question carefully. You have to take down the given information and then proceed with the solutions for part A and part B. In Orange County, 51% of the adults are males. It does not take too much advanced mathematics to deduce that the other 49% are female. One adult is randomly selected for a survey involving credit card usage. Part A is to find the prior probability that the selected person is a male. Okay, let's start with part A. Let us use the notations like alphabet M for male and C for cigar smokers. Okay. So obviously M complement would be female and C complement would be not a cigar smoker. Instead the C, I'm just going to use dash. So before using the information given in part B, we know only that 51% of the adults in the Orange County are males. So the probability of randomly selecting an adult and the adult should be a male is given by probability of male, which is nothing but 51%. So that's it for part A. Hope you're clear with this example. Okay, now let us move on to part B. So part B question, okay, let's read the question. It's later learned that the selected survey subject was smoking a cigar. Also, 9.5% of males smoke cigars, whereas 1.7% of females smoke cigars. So based on the data, okay, use this additional information to find the probability that the selected subject is a male. The first part is a prior probability and this one is posterior probability after some information. Okay, so based on the additional given information, we have identified that probability of M is 0.51. So what would be probability of M dash? The remaining, so 0.49. So this is because 51% of the adults are male, and probability of M dash because 49% of the adults are female, not males. Probability of cigar smokers given they are male is equal to 0.095 because 9.5% of males smoke cigars, whereas, okay, so because 9.5% of the male smokes cigars, that is the probability of getting someone who smokes cigar given that the person is a male is 0. I'm just rewriting the percentage in decimals. Now let's find the probability of C given M dash. That information is also given directly in the question itself. Because 1.7% of the male smokes cigars, female smokes cigars, that is the probability of getting someone who smokes cigar given that the person is a female is 0.017. Okay, let us now apply Baye's theorem by using the formula with M in the place of A and C in the place of B, the formula that we just discussed. So I'm just going to rewrite the same Baye's formula using these alphabets M and C. Hope you're clear with this step. I have just rewritten the Baye's theorem using the variables M and C instead A and B. Okay, so let us just plug in all the information given in the question in the respective places and then do the algebraic calculation. If I do the calculation, I'm getting 0.853. You can also check whether you're getting the same value. So before we knew that the survey subject smoked a cigar, there is a 0.51 probability, 51% of probability that the survey subject is male. Okay. However, after learning that the subject smoked a cigar, we revised the probability to 0.853. So, there is a 0.853 probability that the cigar smoking respondent is a male. So, this makes sense, no? Because the likelihood of a male increases dramatically with the additional information that the subject smokes cigar. Because so many more males smoke cigars than females. Hope you're clear with this example. For all these problems, read the questions thoroughly. Do not miss any given information. And frame all the given informations and set up the formula and plug in the values and simplify it. It is all in identifying the given information. Actually, Baye's theorem problems are very simpler. In case if you get any query regarding this video, please let me know. See you in the